Hey, how's it going, everybody? YouTube, the Explicit91. Today I'm gonna do another commentary video with HD settings. So today's match is gonna be with the UMP on Invasion. My setup is the UMP with Silencer, Stinger, Marathon Pro, Stopping Power Pro, and what else? I think I have one more. Oh, Commando Pro. I have Stun Grenade and Semtex on this class. This is a pretty solid class. It's more for close range maps, more closed off maps. Maps like Wasteland and such are not gonna work just as well with this, but it's really good for close range maps. My aim is a bit off again this match because I haven't been on this game for a while, but since I gotta finish these requests soon, because once Bioshock 2 comes out, I'm off Call of Duty, so keep that in mind, you guys. I'm gonna be off Call of Duty soon, and yeah. So let's go ahead and back to the match. So I'll go ahead and find that we're losing pretty bad already. It's 300 to 1,000, and which is like 3 deaths to like 10 deaths. So I get that first death on my side really fast, and you can see some horrible aiming right now. But I did pick up a double kill before that one guy took me out. The first kill death I had was by a sniper. But I didn't really care, so I go ahead, keep on running. I go to the opposite side of where my team's at because I'm protecting them from being flanked. I know my team is pretty much not worried about that, but since I want to win the match, I have to watch all corners of what I can. So as you can see, I go and see if I can try to flank them if I can. Now the UMP is a very, very good weapon. It's especially better with silencer in my opinion. Red dot sight, I don't know, I can't really get into red dot sight because of I don't know, it seems for me it seems like red dot sight I'm getting like more recoil, but that's just me. But with silencer it's more steady and I can handle it better. Now there's a couple people in this match in the opposite team. About 4 of them have like two or three of them have the freaking marathon lightweight and care package thing where you run faster. Basically, for those who don't know, is that if you have marathon lightweight and you have a care package in your hand, but don't throw the care package, just run with it, you run like double the speed, like as if you had 2 lightweights on, which is really annoying, but I guess you guys gotta know somehow. So I pick up some quick kills in this match. So far from what I saw, my team was still losing, but not by much now. My whole goal was to not die as much, so a lot of times in the I stay back, so I don't want my team to like take too many deaths in, so because I don't want them to include a death from my side and a death from their side, and it'll add up to the final score. So I keep on trying to pick up the sentry gun, but it's just not going. I had to switch weapons like 6 times just to pick up a sentry gun, but as the sentry gun does not help me at all this match as I would hope. So right now I'm 10-4. I have double digits in my team. My other team has nothing, so I get taken out pretty fast. I think my final score this match was like 20 something and 9, I think. I'm not really sure, but we'll find out. So I'm watching it right now as I'm doing the commentary. So I can see I'm going complete opposite sides from my team. I go to where people usually won't go to, because like all those guys going for quick sneak kills, I'm more the counter to that. And there's one of the care package runners. But yeah, sorry that I haven't been making too many Call of Duty videos. Like I said before, if I upload everything randomly, and I don't really stick to one game. So if you subscribe to me, it's just for Call of Duty. You gotta know that I may not be on Call of Duty forever, especially when Bioshock 2 and Dante's Inferno is coming out. I'm gonna be off this game for a long time. So I'll probably be on it just casually with friends, but I probably won't record it. That's about it. But the match goes pretty well. We're still losing by 3. 47 to 51. Oh, it's like a Yeah, now it's 3 again. So I look everywhere. I don't even know. And you see my horrible aim right there. For some reason, I thought I would get a headshot, but nothing. So I had to lower my aim. So now this is a fail right here. I thought my ally killed this guy, and this guy was just hiding in the corner. I've been noticing more that the team's been hiding this whole match, and it's been really annoying. So that Harrier is helping us out a lot this match, so I just go ahead and clear out the far end of the map, because with Marathon I could go run faster. That Mardon almost got me, but I get killed by something else, a sniper. And for some reason I thought that Harrier was the enemies, even though I just said it was not, but I just switched it out. They're getting some fail aiming right there. I thought I would shoot through the window, but I guess not. Now when I reload half the time I drop shot, not really, just pretty much drop then reload, because when they run into the room you have time to reload before, like, finish your reload. And when I reload when I'm standing up, it usually fails, so I just crouch down. So now we're up ahead by 5, wait, so 4, yeah, about 5, or I don't know how many now. I'm not really paying attention to the score, I'm just watching the match itself. So as you can see, my commentary is pretty ghetto, because I'm not really, I'm just saying what comes to mind while I'm playing this. So go ahead, pick up that guy from getting my ally, and get the final kill at the end. And that's it, pulled up the final kill. I'm not sure what was my score at the end, but I guess we'll see right now. Yeah, 20-9, yeah, it was. And everyone else had, like, just barely positives and some negatives, and yeah. And that's it. Alright, guys, I'm not sure if I'm gonna do more commentary, but you never know. I always surprise myself when I do these.